welcome to this promo information or help video about this Android app called Fingerboard Visualizer. I have already installed the app on this virtual Android device. You can see the icon here, so I just press it to start this app. This app is not the app you want to run on a very small Android device, like a watch or something like that. You should at least have a 4-inch screen with resolution 800 by 480. If you have something like a 5-6-7-inch Android device and with the resolution like 1280 by 720 or even better, that would be even better. Of course, that is because when you operate and use this app, you see here that the spacing between the highest frets will be very small on a small device, so it will be hard to operate. And also the image quality will be better on a device with higher resolution. But when saving to image, the app is always using the same image size resolution. So no different there. Even if you're using a small device, you will get the same resolutions of all image, the same high quality. So I myself have used this app on an Android device with 800 by 480 pixel resolution, 4-inch screen, and okay to use, but I must really say that I find it a lot more and better to operate on a bigger device. Like I have also this Samsung Galaxy Tab Pro 8x4-inch screen, I believe it have. And that is an excellent device to use this kind of app on. Then what can we use this app for? You can use it to explore and visualize string instrument fingerboards, visualize chords and scales or the patterns on the fingerboard, explore different tunings and fingerboards with 1 to 10 strings, explore inversions of chords, explore modes of scales, explore harmonies or chords of scales, and general make different fingerboard layouts and save to image for self-study, use when teaching others, publish on the internet, or maybe even use image in books or something like that. We have some definitions or concepts to first explain here. I can activate what I call a note on the fingerboard. Sometimes I say I enter or activate or input a note. I mean the same with all of these. And you also delete it by pushing it again like this. And this is also an ordinary note, I call it. We have something I call a global note. If I activate this now, you will see that this is E activated in all possible positions on this 15 fret fingerboard. So when you have a note activated in all possible positions, all octaves of that note active at the same, then this global note. If I delete one of them now like this, then now this note will be not a global note but an ordinary note. It's not very important, but sometimes global notes are treated a bit different than ordinary notes, especially when you add and remove strings, when you retune, or when you use the transpose function. That's because if you have a note that is global, like this E now, the app is guessing that since this is a global note, you probably want to see it global all over the fingerboard, even if you add or remove strings or change tuning or transpose. But we will show you that later in this video. Then we have the three main operation modes of this app. That is main mode, which we are now already in. Then we have the ghost mode, which you enter by pressing this ghost mode button here. When you see this red circle around a button, the button is active, so we are now in ghost mode. And to leave it, we press it again and we are now back to main mode. Then the third operation mode is this manual mode. You press this button here. We are now in manual mode. The button changes its location, but don't care about that. You also see that a lot of the other buttons have changed. I'll explain that later. To leave this manual mode, we press this button again. So you have now main mode, which we are now in. And if there's a red circle about this button, we are in ghost mode. And if it's a red circle about this button, we are in manual mode. So as long as there's no red circle about this button or this button here, we are in main mode. Here in main mode, as I said, you can activate some notes here. And you have the option to display only color, or display note names, or display intervals, like this. You see, we have a 1 here, so that must be the tonic. And to change tonic, you can go into this change tonic, delete ordinary note function or button here. There are also 3 input delete modes, what we should call them. That is this button, which is the single note input delete. Then you have this one, which is the change tonic or delete single note. And then we have this button, which is enter global note or delete global. So let's see here. We have, as you can see, we have here a standard E major chord. I use this search button here now. When we use this, it will show us both the tonic, the chord name and the scale name, if it's found anything. We now can change the tonic. If we want to change it to a G, I can press a G here. And if we use the search button, you will see that we have a tonic G. To change back to E, you can just delete the E here and enter again, and it will be changed. So when you use this input delete function or mode here, if you press the location where there already are a note, it will first be deleted, and then you can press another position to change the tonic. It's a bit important to understand that this app always have an active tonic, even if we delete every note now. You can see if I push this search button now, it will show us that the tonic is still E. So you can never completely delete tonic. The app will always have active tonic, but you can of course always change the tonic to whatever you want. Just remember that. Then we have the third input delete mode, and this is the global input delete. So when we have this button here active and I push somewhere on this fretboard, you will input the global note, as I explained earlier, or a note that is active all over the fingerboard in every possible position. This is of course the fast way to input notes if you want to input scales all over the fingerboard or some chords like this one, or E major 7th chord in every possible position all over the fingerboard. Because we have only 12 possible notes in the 12 tone chromatic scale which we are using. So to enter every note in every possible position here, you could just push all these 12 different notes, and the same when you want to delete, you just had to push 12 different positions. So sometimes you may delete everything, and you can use this eraser button here to delete every active notes on the fingerboard. Other times you maybe just want to delete a few of these notes, and of course then you can go into this global input delete and just delete the ones you are want to delete, like I did now. So that is so far so good. I explained about the main mode, the ghost mode, which I will show you now soon, and the manual mode. And then we have the single input delete, the tonic change or regular note delete, and the global note input delete, and the eraser button, the search button. I should also say here that a main feature of this app is not searching for chords and scales. So this app don't have a complete list of scales and chords. It only got the most used common seven tone scales, some pentatonic and the blues scale, diminished scale, yes, and chords from these common scales, typically 3, 4, 5 tone chords, but also maybe some 6 or even 7. But again, the main point of this app is not chord or scale searching, but sometimes it's helpful to just verify that you have the right notes active, or of course if you just want to see the name of the chord you maybe got in, you can try and see if the app finds it. Also remember that when you have a chord like this now and search E major 9, we are using the tonic here, which is the E. If you wanted to explore or see if this could also be another possible chord, you can just change the tonic to one of the other notes and search again to see if that would give you something new. But I'm not sure if that's really something that people find useful. I'm just mentioning it because the app is using this as tonic now, and to see if you have some other chords which include the same notes, you can of course change one of these notes to tonic also to see if that is the situation. Sometimes that is useful information, especially when you are searching for chord substitutions, but again, chord search and scale search is not the main feature of this app, so I've not included a lot of different options there. I think I explained most of the points there in main mode, but you see here we have now a E major 7th chord, and we have these move notes buttons. You use them here in main mode. You can, when we have a chord like this, you can use them to move the notes up and down the fingerboard, and by you using this, you are exploring the different inversions of this chord. That is very useful. All these inversions can be substituted from the starting chord, so this can be used if you want to find some new fresh sounding chords instead of playing again the same basic chord. And of course this you can use with every possible chord. It's just to enter a chord you first start with and then use this button to search around. But if you have something like global note here, you cannot use these buttons because when a note is global, it is already in all possible positions and there is nowhere this note now can move. So we have to have some free space, typically some free strings. So that's why also I'm input this E major 7th chord like this to see the different inversions of this chord. Also here in main mode you can activate a scale. Let's see that now. I'm inputting E major or Ionian scale. I got now three notes each string. I got a repeating fifth there, but that's not very important now. But let's see here, we have the E major Ionian scale. To see this scale in different inversions, or what they call modes, we can walk up and down again here, and you see the different positions here. Let go again up one step to the second position here. You see that the tonic now is this second, this G flat. But when we are exploring modes, it's more useful to see this one now as a tonic. We could of course use this change tonic button now, just delete and add it again and we would change the tonic. But let's go down one step and I will show you this function here that is called move tonic. And you have a red circle around this button here, you have the move tonic function on. And watch, when I now press one step up, you'll see that the tonic moves from E to G flat, like that. And if you now search there, you will see that we have a G flat Dorian. So this move tonic is very useful when you are showing intervals and you want to explore the different modes of scales. And also later I'm going to show you in ghost mode when you explore harmonies or chords of scales. So you see now the tonic is moved up as we move up or down, as we move down. And again, of course, you can explore these modes of scales with every possible scale. It's just for you to enter what to start with, as we did also when we explored the inversions of chords. So these two possibilities is really two of the main points of use of this app, to explore inversions of chords and inversions of scales, or what they call modes of scale. Now we're gonna take a look at the second operation mode, that is called ghost mode. We have the ghost mode button here, but let me first show you what happens if you already have some notes on the fingerboard active and you try to enter ghost mode. You get the warning, remove all active notes before entering ghost mode. So just press the erasure button or something and then you can enter ghost mode. The reason why that is so is because here in ghost mode you first start by activating what I call ghost notes, like you see now. Typically this will be a scale that you first input with these ghost notes. Also ghost notes are always global, as you see when I enter and delete some ghost notes there. Then when you have finished entering the scale or whatever with the ghost notes, you can activate this single input delete ordinary note, and then you can activate some ordinary notes on top of these ghost notes. So the point here is that you now can use this move notes button to start to move these ordinary notes on top within this scale already first entered by the ghost notes. So this is diatonic movement, really, everything you do here in ghost mode, because you are restricted to only move within the ghost notes that you first entered. And by doing this, you can explore harmonies or chords of scales. So let's see that. I have no active move tonic that is useful here. So we now have a E major 7th chord, and I move up one step and the tonic are moved. And we now have a G flat minor 7th chord, and you can move up again and see again how the different chords you get from this scale. And of course you can go to another string set if you want and repeat moving here and walk down or up again, and you can go down again to where we started. And this is also possible for every possible scale, because we can just delete ordinary notes, then we deactivate this ordinary note input delete, and now you can start to change the ghost notes there. So I remove this third and change it to a minor third. Then we have E melodic minor scale. I can add some ordinary notes again. I can enter this one here and some yellow here. These color note buttons on the bottom here are just colors. They have no other function in this app, so it's all up to you how you want to use them. But sometimes it is nice to have different colors for the different intervals, just to visualize that. So it's all up to you to decide how you want to use them. for better visualize whatever you want. But let's see now. We have changed the ghost notes to E melodic minor and added four note chord on top of that. And we should have the E minor major 7th chord. And now you can walk up again and again have the move tonic active here. And we now see the chords we get from this scale. So I believe you get the point there and see the use of this ghost mode. This may be the most powerful or useful feature of this app. Of course, if you only want to display some intervals or notes all over the fingerboard and save the image and print that and use whatever you want, that is also very useful, but here we get some more information, I believe. I can change back to the E major scale, and I'll show you one more thing here. That is not only exploring harmonies or chords of scales you can do here. Generally, you can explore diatonic movement. Diatonic movement is when you are only using the notes from the key or scale we have. So that would be the E major scale now, since that is what these ghost notes are restricted or limiting us to use now. So I can really enter whatever notes there. Like this would be some kind of chord only by fourth interval instead of third. So when you are doing this, sometimes also it is more, or it's not so interesting to see really the intervals at all. So we can just change to only color, and we can also turn off the move tonic function. So then you can start to move this shape within this scale. So we are now exploring diatonic movement with this shape, and of course change to a different string set, and again see how it moves around. We could quickly go down again here and change to another shape, this one, and again start moving it around and see how it turns out. Of course you can just also enter some more fewer notes. You can do this by using any kind of interval and see how it moves around, changing string set again. Here we have a major triad. We can again move it around. So this is exploring diatonic movement within the scale that we first entered with the ghost notes. And again, you can change the ghost notes to be whatever scale you want and explore the diatonic movement. Really nice feature. You should of course practice this on your real instrument, but you can see here how the different shapes will move, and then take notice and practice that on your instrument. Learn the scale, of course, all over your fingerboard, and this kind of diatonic movement should really come to you sooner or later if you just practice your instrument long enough. But nice to see here also how these shapes move around. So again, here in ghost mode, we have possibility to explore harmonies or chords of scales. We also can explore diatonic movement, like you have seen now. If you have some notes active here and you want to delete them, you of course can push one by one. You can also use the eraser button here to erase every ordinary note. If you want to erase everything at once, just press the ghost mode button like I'm doing now. Then everything is gone, and when you press ghost mode button again, you enter it and you start all over and you can enter these ghost notes again. So with that said, I think we are completely finished with the ghost mode, and we move on to next operation mode. I have already told you about the first operation mode, which is main mode, and I have just explained you about the second operation mode, which is ghost mode, and then we have the third operation mode, which is manual mode. So to enter manual mode, you press this button here, and now we are in manual mode. You see the buttons have changed a lot. That's because here in manual mode, you have complete and full manual control over everything. By that I mean you can decide which color you want all these notes to be, and what they should display on top, the labels. Like you can use these letters for note names, or you can use these numbers for intervals. You can also use 1, 2, 3, 4 for left hand fingers, and that's why I included the T, because that is for the thumb. But if you want to use this like something like for tapping, that's up to you to decide. To change color, you just repeatedly press this color button here. And since we are in full manual control now, the app is not doing very much for you behind here. So if I just activate E here, I now activate the E, but I could change that to A by just changing the label here to A. So you see, you override completely the setup that is behind there. We have a standard 6-string tuned guitar here, but here in manual mode you can enter exactly as you want. The only little help you get here in manual mode is when using global activate delete. Then the app will see what tuning and what note name positions are behind here. So if I activate again here, you will see that it's activated globally, this E all over the fingerboard. But as I choose to display this with A, that's okay for me. But you see the pointer, the manual mode is giving you this option to do exactly what you want. So let's go back to single input delete. If I here input the A, you have here on this button here, you have the accidentals, so we can change to the flat here. You get the flat, and if you want the sharp, you can get the flat sharp here. The sharp symbol is only available here in the manual mode. In the other modes, like main and ghost mode, the app is always using the flat symbol. So let's see now. You can of course also do the same with numbers here, like this. And as this mode is manual, I have also not restricted anything here. So you can add a sharp one and a flat one if you really want. And even the same with the thee. But what you want to use that for, I don't know. But maybe some people find that useful, I'm not sure. But the point is here, you can use all these options to display exactly as what you want. And of course you can change the color here also. So that is the manual mode, and when you have it as you want, you can save the image by using this button here. But let's go back to main mode. One thing is that when we are in manual mode, you see this fingerboard and these notes now. If you go back to main mode, I could activate some notes here. Let's again input the E major chord. If I now go back to manual mode, see now you see that the notes are still here. So the fingerboard here in manual mode are separate from what you have in manual mode or in ghost mode. So you can enter whatever you want here, and it will be saved even if when you leave this manual mode and come back. So here in main mode, I have already explained everything. I know I have explained the main mode, the ghost mode, and the manual mode. We now shall see another feature of this app that is here on this button here. That is the setup setup menu. But I just remember I forgot one thing here, and that is another function in this app. We have seen a move tonic function that moves the tonic. If you press this button once more, you will see this icon, and this is the icon for the transpose function. So when I have this active and use the move note buttons, you will see everything is just transposed up or down one fret. You see, and just notice that if I move something, ordinary notes, above the 15th fret, the notes will be deleted. Also the same if you move ordinary notes below open position or zero fret, they will be also deleted. And here is one of the situation where the global notes would be treated different, because if I have a global note like this E now, and I start to transpose this around, you will see that the app is keeping that note as global. And as I said before, that is because the app is guessing that since this note is global, you want probably to see it as global even when you transpose it up and down like I'm doing now. But if you got some ordinary notes also here like this one now, and I now start to transpose again, what you will see is that ordinary notes like these, because they are not global, they will be deleted when they are moved above 15th fret or below zero. So let's see that now I'm moving here, and if I'm going down again, you see the note is deleted. Same with this one here. So just be aware of that if you have some notes active here and you start to transpose, because sometimes when you have almost a global note like this G now, if I delete this one, this will now not be a global note. So if I now start to transpose, you'll see that the notes are deleted as I move them above or below the range of this fingerboard. All right. So that was the transpose function. Also here in ghost mode, if you have some notes there, I turn first off the transpose, and if you now start to move this around, all good. If you now wanted to transpose everything up to the A, you can turn on the transpose function, then move everything up to A. What you see now is that tonic did not move. That is because the tonic is not moved when you use this transpose. So you have to change the tonic. I did not have to deactivate the transpose, I just did that now. But now I changed the tonic, and we have a major 7th. And I turned off the transpose because I just want to show you that now of course we can explore the different chords of this A major scale. When you use the search button, you see that we find no scale here. That is because only ordinary notes are used when you search for chords or scales. Ghost notes are never used. They are just notes you first input, so ordinary notes have something to move on top on. Then I'm going to explain you about setups. In the setup menu, we have the active setup, that is what you are using all the time. You have number of strings which you can change from 1 to 10. You have the option to display frets, to display dots. And then you have the tuning of every string. There is a lower and upper tuning range, but that is very low and very high. And then you have this option here to use a white fingerboard background. Some people like to save to image with white fingerboard background. Let's see that now. That's because when you save to JPEG image, the image size will be much less. So it's faster to download from the internet for people. And not to forget that if you print this one here, you will save a lot of ink because there are only white there, of course, if you are using white paper. But let's change back to this wood texture now. And so we have this active setup, and you can change this as you want. We could hide the frets and the dots. Let's go back and see. This is how it's now. Then we can activate just frets if you want. Now we have frets, or change to just the dots, like this. Also, of course, you can say change this as you want. And then you can save this active setup to one of these saved setups. Saved setups, and even also the active setup, is saved to a file in the folder or directory location of your app on your Android device. So even if you completely shut down the Android device and or restart it, all this will be saved. But if you uninstall the app, also the file will be deleted, so then everything is gone. But let's see now if we want to switch to something different, or let's first go back here and see what we have now. We have this E major chord, yes. If we retune now, we can retune to what they call a E open tuning. Let's see here now. You see now that the notes we had here are moved down. That's because we tuned the strings up. And now you could play this E major chord by just strumming these open strings. So by first entering some notes or scales or something, and then go in and change the setup, you will see how notes are moved. So you can explore how different tunings change chords or scales. And some people use different tunings, some people don't use them at all. But that's up to you. Also here, if you tune a lot, notes that go below open or zero fret will be deleted. And the same with notes that go above the 15th fret, they will also be deleted. We could change here now to another setup. So to fast change to, let's say, this 7 string guitar setup, use this use button, and the app is asking you if you want to load this setup now into the active setup. So we say yes, and we see that the setup pair has changed and the name has changed for this active setup. We go back and we see that the notes have moved. That's because this 7 string guitar have, of course, different tuning or different range for the different strings. So the notes have to go up to keep them as the same notes that we had for the 6 string guitar. Let's go back here again. If we change to 8 string guitar, you see they are moved even higher. So the notes don't change strings, they're always on the same string. They just move to the new correct position on the strings. And if we change to something completely different, like a violin 4 string, and go back, you see now what I told you, that sometimes when the notes go above or below the range of the active setup, the notes will be deleted. Also here in violin setup, like we have now, we are not showing frets or dots. It will be, of course, very hard to input notes, but you can, of course, go in and activate the frets, and then you can activate notes more easily. Also, when you enter and delete notes, you should push some where here close to the fret, as you use or as you do on a reel guitar or whatever your instrument is. You don't push in the middle, then nothing will happen. Go close to the fret. All right. Of course, here on the higher frets, it's less bass, or you could just press near the middle. But then, let's go back here and change again to the standard guitar here. That was not the right one. This one, yes. If you want to save your setup, you of course just press one of these safety buttons, and you can change the name of this setup to whatever you want, but only the 50 first letters are used or saved. And when you have changed the name as you want, you just press OK. So let's see if we maybe we want first to load this violin setup like now. I mean, I want to save that to, let's say, this position cell, the third position. Of course, you should change the name to something more correct now. That would be more right. And when you have changed the name as you want, you can just press OK, and you will see that the name is displaying here now. And if you want to now also load this into the active, because the name here will not cannot be changed. To change the name here, you have to load one of these setups like this, and then the name will be updated also. So that's really all I have to say about this setup options here. You can activate 10 strings if you want. Go in and you have strings all over here. Activate dots and frets. Like you see now, the tuning for these four highest strings are the same, but of course you could change that to something else. Let's load the guitar 8th string. Oh, I did earlier, I just saved the violin here. So let's use instead this 7th string, alright. And then we add some strings. When you add strings or move strings, if nothing has been here before, the app will suggest a note that is a fourth above, as you see here. But if this note had something before, like we are tuning right now to a B4, we now move down, and if we now move up again, the app will remember what it had before, so it will suggest the same note at this had before. So now, going back out to this 10 string setup, you can see now we have this B all over this 10 strings, and of course you can just change to this 6 string and have it back to more common setup like this, standard 6 string. So that is the way you can change number of strings and showing or hiding frets and dots, and turn on the white fingerboard background, and save these setups as you want. The white fingerboard background is not saved with these setups. This is standing by itself, so this you have to turn on or turn off as you want. And of course, if you messed up something here and you want to go back to the setups that comes with the app, as it is installed, you just press this reset all, and you press yes sir, and you are back to how the app is when you first install it. Then we have another feature here that is maybe the most important for some users, that is the save to image. You have that in this button here, and you have the option to save to JPEG and to PNG. JPEG is smaller in size, PNG is lossless compression, as I say. If you want to save two images for use in print, I'm thinking about now books or other publication, you should use PNG. If you want to use the image on the internet or something else, then use JPEG. We have also the option to save the 15 fret fingerboard, the complete app that is with everything, including the buttons and fingerboard, or you can only save the fingerboard. And for the 24 fret fingerboard, because we only have 15 frets, I have some options there that should cover most or all needs. The first one here is when you have typically some global notes all over the fingerboard. I want also to show them on the all over the 24 fret fingerboard. You can use this one. The second here is when you only want to show and have notes on the 0 to 15 fingerboard, but you want to show the complete 24 fret fingerboard. And this third here is when you only have notes in between 8 and 19 frets. You see here, since you are using a 15 fret fingerboard, we don't have to input notes here between 4 and 19, and notes between 4 and 7 will be moved to the higher frets, 16 to 19. I hope I now explained this correct, but just try this out yourself. May also note that notes on lowest fret from 0 to 3rd will be kept if you have something like something there. So if you don't want something there, just remove them first. Then you have this fourth option here, that notes on fret 0 to 12 are moved to fret 12 to 24. So this you use when you only have notes to display on the higher frets. And because these first four options here are a bit limited, we have also this fifth option here. And to get full control over the 24 fret fingerboard, we have to save in two parts. You are saving to memory. So when you push this button here and then push first this button, what you have on the fingerboard are copied to the 24 fret fingerboard, fret 0 to 11, and when you push, then typically you return back here and change it for what you want on higher frets, and then you push this button here, and then what you have on the 0 to 12 fret are copied to this two-part 22 fret fingerboard to the fret 12 to 24. And these parts are saved first to memory, and you don't have to push the save button to really save to an image file. Because these parts are now saved to memory, if you change something now, like the spacing here, then you will see that these are removed. So you again have to save these parts. The same is true if you go into the setup and change different number of strings, then also these parts will be removed, so we have to save them again. But let us see now what we have here now. We have this E. We can activate some more notes there now. And we can go back here and we can save the complete app first. And then we can save only fingerboard. And I can also use this first 24 fret fingerboard option here to save to 22 4 fret fingerboard. And now, to find the image, you have to go into the Android device gallery. And let's see the image we got there. This is the 24 fret fingerboard, and we are using the correct spacing. By that I mean that the fretboard spacing will be as a real guitar. If you use the compressed, the image width will be less, image size will be smaller. So just use this correct space if that is important for you, else use the compressed. So this was the 24 fret fingerboard. We can then change here and see the 15th fret fingerboard, and we have here the complete app with everything, buttons and everything. To delete the image, you just of course delete the image as usual here in this gallery app on your Android device. Let's go back to the app now. And change to the compressed 24 fret fingerboard, so you just can see that. And also, if you wanted to use the white fingerboard background, you have to go in here in setup and activate that. Go back to the save screen here, and we can use only the fingerboard. You could also just change some colors there just to this, to see that we get something different there. Yes, something like that. E major 7th chord with some different colors for different intervals. And we want to save that, so it's already here, so save. Go back into the image gallery of your Android device. I'm running this app now on a virtual Android device, so sometimes it's a bit slow here. But I think you see everything that's needed there. This is the white background, but you see different colors from these intervals. You can see the compressed spaced 24 fret fingerboard. See if the spacing now is less here. If 5, and I did delete the other one, yes. But the image size for this one is less, so the image take less storage, faster for people to download, and use the correct space only if you really need it. Yes, and last thing here to show you is that we also have this information button here, help information. It just lists the three operation modes, like I said, main mode, ghost mode, manual mode. Then we have three modes for input or delete notes. We have the single note input to delete, tonic input or change ordinary note. And you have the global note input to delete. Then you have the three options to display notes, only color, note name, with intervals. And then we have the move notes buttons here. This is really all I just included in this one here. So you move notes to next ordinary note or ghost note. And then you have the move tonic function here, and you have the transpose function here. Erase button, save to image, change setup, show tonic, search chord or scale, then a short explanations of what you can use the different operation modes for, and other features. So I think that is really all there is to say about this app. It's not that hard to use this app really. So that is all I had to say about this app. Again, I find this useful when exploring new scales, learning new scales to see different positions, modes, find the chords. Also when I'm learning to play different chords in different inversions around the fingerboard, like I'm now. Let's say we wanted to explore this dominant 7th chord around the fingerboard. Just input and start moving around. See the different inversions of the chords. All these chords you can use for substitute all the others. Very useful. So happy practicing, have a good time. Bye bye.